Hey guys, my name is Kaushik and welcome back to LitCode. In this video, we are going to learn how to handle the shadow DOM using Playwright. It's going to be very simple. Trust me, it's a very, very, very simple. Okay. So I believe already you are aware of what is shadow DOM and why it is implemented and how to handle that in Selenium. If not, probably you can watch my previous two videos. In this video, I'm just going to tell you like how to handle it in Playwright. And trust me, it is very easy. I'm going to take two scenarios. The first one we'll take from LitCode.in, where we have like open shadow and the closed shadow. Unfortunately, we do not have a way to handle the closed shadow DOM, but of course we can interact with the open shadow DOM. So if I go and inspect this element, you can see that it is basically within the open shadow root and it has an ID called fname, right? So I'm just going to copy the ID value and here I'm going to say await page dot fill. And within that, I'm going to pass my ID as a CSS locator. And then I'm going to pass my data to type. Okay, that's it. We are done. That's it. It's very simple, right? Let me try to execute and show you. So I'm going to bring up my terminal and going to run this test case. Watch carefully. So I typed my name and it completed as well, right? But if you notice something, the test completed very soon. So just to show you, I'm just going to add kind of delay here. So for that, we have a function called page.waitForTimeout. And within that, we can pass the seconds, like I'm going to pass for 3 seconds. Okay. This is not necessary, but just to show you the output, like it's typed, I'm going to introduce that. Okay, so here you can see that we have typed the value successfully. That's it, very simple. If you watched my previous video in Selenium, probably you know the pain, but here in Playwright, it's very, very easy. Okay, so we'll take one more scenario. So here we have this website called Chromium Bugs, and here I'm going to handle this dropdown as well as I'm going to type in this input. Okay, so let's go and inspect. So it is basically right, like within one root, there is another root. For example, if I go here, you can see that and this is my body and within that I have something like mr-app and within that this is my first shadow root. Okay, and within that I have this particular drop down. Okay, so here you can see that it's a parent root, basically shadow root, and here it has a ID called can. Okay, so I'm just going to copy that and here I'm going to store that. So await page dot locator and ID, it's a, of course we can use only the CSS, we cannot use the XPath within the shadow DOM. So of course we have to go with any of the CSS. And then I'm going to store that here. Okay. And of course we'll write a if condition here. If element is there, we'll do something else, we'll throw an error. Okay. So throw new. Okay. That's it. Now within this, what we are going to do, we are going to handle the dropdown. So I believe you already remember the dropdown code. So I'm just going to say like element dot select option, and within that I'm going to pass the label, and let's go and select something. So I'm going to maybe select like this one, issue to verify. Okay, so I'm just going to copy paste. Okay, and here. Sorry. Yeah, so that's it. We are pretty much done with handling the dropdown. Okay, and next we are going to type something here in this particular text box. Okay, so here you can see that we have an ID called search queue, but before that we see here we have one shadow root and above that we have another shadow root. Okay, so basically it's like nested shadow root. So what I'm trying to say is basically we no need to worry about like how many parent we have or how many child we have. By default, Playwright can iterate through each and every shadow root and it will find based on the CSS value we are going to give. Okay, there might be a situation where we can have duplicate elements, but of course you should know how to write a unique CSS locator. Okay, it's going to be very simple because if you see most of the shadow root have like minimal kind of elements, so it will be little easy. Okay, so now let's go and interact with the input. So it's going to be again same await page.fill. And first of all, we'll pass our locator, that is ID, and then we'll pass our test data. Okay, so let's say some bug. Again, it will close very quickly. So I'm just going to add a timeout here so that we can see the result. Now let's go and execute this one. Okay, so here you can see that the text, the sum bug is also typed, and then the issues to verify also selected. Okay, so in this way we can handle any of the drop down or checkbox or whatever the basic elements we have in our web page. Of course we can select that. We don't need to do anything like to say like particularly we are trying to find this element. Instead of that, just give the unique locator. If it's outside of the DOM, shadow DOM, that is regular DOM, or also called as like light DOM, that will also work. And if the locator is within the shadow root, that will also work. Okay, so that's it for this video. If you have any queries, do let me know in the comments, and I will recommend you to go and read this documentation where we have like a few more examples, so you will get a good idea. Okay, so that's it. Thanks for watching. See you in the next one very soon.